Now we'll study the topic of wave-particle duality. This has been a topic of debate in long back among scientists, those who were doing research on wave nature and particle nature of light as well as matter. Now we are going to study about wave-particle duality in two cases. The very first is wave-particle duality for light. And we'll discuss wave-particle duality for matter. In wave-particle duality for light, long back there were two physicists. One was Huygens and other was Newton. Those who have done research and based on their research, they have presented their theoretical model. And Huygens said that light is a wave. And Newton said that light is a stream of particle. And the theory which were given by Huygens was known as the Huygens theory of wavefront propagation. And the theory of Newton was called corpuscular theory of light propagation, in which Newton said that light is a stream of particles and these particles are known as corpuscles of light. And later on there were several evidences in the favor of Huygens' theory. However, both Huygens and Newton were not able to exactly prove in experimental analysis about the theories given by them. But later on, finally Huygens' theory were accepted all over by Maxwell's discovery, Maxwell's theory of electromagnetic radiations, in which Maxwell has proven that light is composed of electric and magnetic field oscillations and light can be treated as an electromagnetic wave. And various experimental evidences like Young's double slit experiment, diffraction of light are well-versed evidences which proves that light is a wave. And by that time it was well accepted that light must be regarded as a wave. But in parallel in 18th century with the Albert Einstein's theory of photoelectric effect, it was proven that light must also behave like a particle. This theory was also called photon theory of light, in which Einstein said that light is a stream of particles which are actually the packets of energy given a name photon. That means light is a stream of particles in which electromagnetic energies contain, and such particles are named as photons. So there were a lot of evidences in favor of particle theory as well as wave theory, and later on it was mutually accepted all over that light is treated like a particle as well as like a wave, depending on the situational requirement, what kind of experiment we are performing, in which one nature of light is dominating and other nature of light is less dominating, or we can say is less visible. Similar to this wave-particle duality for light, later on it was considered that the same wave-particle duality can also exist for matter. It was later on taken up on the basis of Einstein's photon theory, in which Einstein has calculated the momentum of photons, which was analyzed in detail by de Broglie. And he has given de Broglie's hypothesis of matter waves, in which he has given details that moving particles, physical particles, can also be treated like a wave. That means physical particles have their inertial character as well as some wave character, and the wave character of a moving particle increases with their momentum. So this we are going to discuss in detail in later sections of the chapter. Right now you just keep in mind that both of these concepts are quite important to be understood here. That is, a light can be treated like a wave as well as a particle. That means light carries all wave characteristics as well as particle like inertial characteristics. Similarly, when we talk about physical matter, it carries inertial characteristics as well as, in various situations, the wave characteristics of physical particles may become dominating depending on situational requirements.